where Jesus, you were transfigured on the mount. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ Jesus, you transfigure us through your sacraments. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
And now we accept the promise of being transfigured with you for all eternity. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
And may Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to life everlasting.
Amen.
Now on this great feast we say together, our Lord. Glory
to God.
Transfiguration of your only begotten Son confirmed the mysteries of faith by the witness of the fathers, and wonderfully prefigured our full adoption to sonship. Grant, we pray, to your servants that listening to the voice of your beloved Son, we may merit to become co-heirs with him, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Reading from the book of the prophet Daniel. As I watched, thrones were set up, and the ancient one took his throne. His clothing was bright as snow, and the hair on his head as white as wool. His throne was flames of fire, with wheels of burning fire. A surging stream of fire flowed out from where he sat. Thousands upon thousands were ministering to him, and myriads upon myriads continued attended him. The court was convened, and the books were opened. As visions during the night continued, I saw one like the Son of Man coming on the clouds of heaven. When he reached the Ancient One and was presented before him, the one like the Son of Man received dominion, glory, and kingship. All peoples, nations, and languages served him. His dominion is an everlasting dominion that shall not be taken away. His kingship now shall not be destroyed. The word of the Lord.
Thank you, God.
Please respond, the Lord is King, the Most High over all the earth.
The Lord is King, the Most High.
The Lord is King. Let the earth rejoice. Let the many islands be glad. Clouds and darkness are round about him. Justice and judgment are the foundation of his throne. The Lord is King. The mountains melt like wax before the Lord. Before the Lord of all the earth, the heaven proclaims his justice, and all peoples see his glory.
The Lord is King.
Because you, O Lord, are the Most High over all the earth, exalted far above all gods.
The Lord is
King, the Most High over all the earth. A reading from the second letter of St. Peter. Beloved, we did not follow utterly devised this when we were made known to you. The power and coming of our Lord Jesus Christ, but we have been eyewitnesses of his majesty. For he received honor and glory from God the Father when that unique declaration came to him from the majestic glory. This is my Son, my beloved, with whom I am well pleased. We ourselves heard this voice come from heaven while we were with him on the holy mountain. Moreover, we possess a prophetic message that is altogether reliable. You will do well to be attentive to it, as to a lamp shining in a dark place, until dawn, day dawns, and the morning star rises in your heart. The word of the Lord.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, Lord.
Jesus took Peter, James, and his brother John and led them up a high mountain by themselves. And he was transfigured before them. His face shone like the sun, and his clothes became white as light. And behold, Moses and Elijah appeared to them, conversing with him. Then Peter said to Jesus in reply, Lord, it is good that we are here. If you wish, I will make three tents here, one for you, one for Moses, and one for Elijah. While he was still speaking, behold, a bright cloud cast a shadow over them. Then from the cloud came a voice that said, This is my beloved Son, with whom I am well pleased. Listen to him. When the disciples heard this, they fell prostrate and were very much afraid. Jesus came and touched them, saying, Rise, and do not be afraid. And when the disciples raised their eyes, they saw no one else but Jesus alone. As they were coming down from the mountain, Jesus charged them, Do not tell the vision to anyone until the Son of Man has been raised from the dead. The Gospel of the Lord. I say that this is a great feast, this Feast of the Transfiguration, because life of Christ, it is seen as one of those moments of proof that this truly is the Son of God, that God comes and speaks to him on the mountain. They say, though, when we reflect on the mysteries and the celebrations of the feasts of God in Jesus Christ, we do not really come to a complete understanding of the meaning of until we see how it applies to ourselves. And in that very first opening prayer, we got a glimpse of what this means. We pray, O God, you are confirmed in Jesus Christ the mysteries of faith by the witness of the fathers, and wonderfully prefigure our full adoption to sonship. In other words, from the very beginning, we're saying that as we see how the Son of God, Jesus Christ, is transfigured, we're recognizing that we are all adopted children of God in our baptism, so that somehow we are called to the same transfiguration. Some might say, well, that all happened in heaven. And that's true, because in the communion antiphon today, we say, When Christ appears, we shall be like him, for we shall see him as he being transfigured in that final experience of salvation known as heaven. But we ask ourselves, when does it start? When do we really begin to see the transfiguration within ourselves? And people who have studied it say, you know, it actually begins at baptism. We are called to be the adopted children of God in that act of baptism. And it's our first step at true transfiguration. And today what we're celebrating is not just that Christ has been transfigured on the mountain, but we also celebrate that we are being transfigured each day of our lives, as long as we can say, Lord, I see your grace, I accept it, and I allow it to transform and to transfigure me. It is God's grace that transfigures us, and that is what we celebrate now on this altar. Let us stand. For all those fighting on the front lines, this coronavirus, that they might be kept safe and strong, we pray to the Lord. People throughout the world, especially in Beirut, Lebanon, who suffer tragedies of any kind, that they might be kept safe, we pray to the Lord. For those who support us, those who love us, and those who care for us, we pray to the Lord. In thanksgiving for the gift of transfiguration and a willingness to help to transfigure others in this world, we pray to the Lord. We pray too for all those making decisions about the opening of schools. We pray to the Lord. And for all those who have died, especially for Russell and for Tom McCransky, for whom the Mass is offered, we pray to the Lord. Hear our prayers, Almighty God, on this Feast of the Transfiguration. Renew our commitment to live the grace of Christ each day of our lives through Christ our Lord. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you. Fruit of the earth, the work of human hands, it will become for us the bread of life. By the mystery of this water and wine, may we come to share in the divinity of Christ, who humbled himself to share in our humanity. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you. Fruit of the vine, the work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink. Our gifts are prepared. So pray, my sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty. Sanctify, O Lord, we pray, these offerings here made to celebrate the glorious transfiguration of your only begotten Son. And by his radiant splendor, cleanse us from the stains of sin, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
And the Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your heart.
Lift up the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
Jesus Christ.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Almighty God, through Christ, who is our Lord. For he revealed his glory in the presence of the chosen witnesses, and filled with the greatest splendor that bodily form, which he shares with all humanity, that the scandal of the cross might be removed from the hearts of his disciples, and that he might show how, in the body of the whole church, it is to be fulfilled that he so wonderfully showed forth first in the head. And so with the powers of heaven, we worship you constantly here on earth, and before your majesty without end, we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, ever and ever, holy Lord, most high and highest, blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord, most high and highest.
You are holy indeed, O Lord, the fountain of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the chalice of my blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. When
we eat this bread and drink this cup, we will bring the head forward to his coming.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Almighty God, the bread of life, the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world. Bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis of Rome, Daniel our bishop, Louis his assistant bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray. With the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, your spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God Almighty, Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, for my divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven,
deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days. By the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of the church. And graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other a sign. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord.
Page 162 is our communion antiphon. When Christ is here, we shall not be here, or we shall see him as he is. Thank you. presence. May the heavenly nourishment we have received, O Lord, we pray, transform us into the likeness of your Son, whose radiant splendor you will to make manifest in his glorious transfiguration. For he lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
Amen.
May Almighty God.